And in a rare display of bipartisanship, leaders of the House and Senate Intelligence Committees warned the leaks threatened to do imminent and irreparable damage to our national security. Republican Senator John Cornyn of Texas is a member of the Judiciary Committee. He's also a member of the Armed Services Committee, and he joins us this morning. It's nice to see you, sir. Thank you for talking with us.
Good morning.
We know that the FBI already has launched an investigation into the leaks, and Senator John McCain was telling CNN that he wants President Obama to appoint a special counsel to also do its own investigation. Do you think, in fact, a special counsel needs to be appointed?
I agree. Special counsel was created so that there should be a measure of independence in investigations like this, where the natural tendency of the administration, when it's the subject of the investigation, the natural tendency is to circle the wagons. And I don't believe that Attorney General Holder or his deputy are going to be able to do a truly independent investigation. This is not a partisan issue. As you know, the chair of the Senate Intelligence Committee, Senator Feinstein, said this is the worst leaking she's seen in her time here in Congress. And this is threatening not only the methods, but also the sources and the cooperation of our allies when it comes to two of the most sensitive areas of our national security, that is stopping the Iranian nuclear threat and fighting and taking out al-Qaeda through the drone program. So this is very serious stuff, and I don't think we could just let the White House investigate itself or take its word for it that it is not the source of these leaks.
But I know when you had a conversation with the Deputy Attorney General James Cole, he really wouldn't say whether or not they would do this investigation. Take a look at what he said.
I don't mean to dodge the question, Senator, but obviously we're talking about material that, if it exists, would be very classified. And the existence of it itself, obviously, would be classified. So it's a difficult topic to talk about without treading into the areas of either confirming or denying that such information exists.
In a way, he's saying you could potentially make the problem worse by holding a hearing and compromise what you're actually trying to protect against, right?
Well, what Deputy Attorney General Cole said is exactly the sort of defensive posture that we would expect when it's the administration itself, which is suspected to be the source of the leaks. An investigation into the leaks is not classified, maybe the subject matter of that leak, but right now we've seen both of those displayed on the pages of the New York Times. One story on the president's kill list on al-Qaeda through the drone program documents that David Axelrod, one of his closest political advisors, was sitting in on meetings where those lists of those kill lists were compiled. This is a serious matter. It's much bigger than party or politics, and that's why I think you're seeing such bipartisan concern about these leaks into some of the most sensitive national security programs that exist.
Senator John Cornyn joining us this morning. Thank you, sir. We'll see how those investigations go and have you back to talk about that. We appreciate it.